Today in this video I am going to discuss about why Flipkart, Patanjali group of companies, Zomato may be asked to file their financial statements frequently like listed companies, especially after the amendment of Companies Act 2020. Listed companies like Flipkart, Patanjali, Zomato, MCA may ask for more frequent filings of their financial statements hereafter. Big unlisted companies, MCA may ask for more frequent filings of financial statements. The move does allow the company's regulator to keep a timely check on movement of financial assertions of large unlisted companies. However, private unlisted companies furnish financial data to the RSE only via their annual statements. Due to the recent amendments to the Companies Act 2013, the MCA may direct the large unlisted public companies like Flipkart, Patanjali and Zomato file financial results frequently, like quarterly, half-yearly results filed by the unlisted companies now. Thus, these big unlisted public companies have to file financial statements more frequently with the Register of Companies than the annual periodicity which is existent now. The rationale behind this move is to enable the early fraud detection and statutory compliance. At present, the listed companies have to submit financial results annually to ROC and to upload their financial results on quarterly basis on their websites to stock exchanges under SEBI LODR provisions. However, private companies furnish their financial statements to the ROC only through their annual statements filed in once in a year. The Companies Amendment Act 2020 provided the preparation of financial results of prescribed class of unlisted companies on a periodical basis, that is on quarterly basis. These will be required to be audited or at least to be reviewed by an external auditing professional, like limited review made by the listed companies at present. MCA source informed that MCA will call a meeting of stakeholders later this September 2020 to discuss about the reporting periodicity and the classes of companies that would be asked to file financial statements more regularly. The criteria could include the turnover or paid up capital or combination of both. MCA wants to use this information for the better compliance and to bring in more transparency in functioning of unlisted companies, especially large unlisted companies like Zomato, Flipkart, Amazon and Patanjali. In 2011 and 12, MCA introduced XBRL. One of the features of the XBRL was early fraud deduction it allowed. Besides, listed companies having paid up capital of rupees 5 crore or more above, and those with the turnover of 100 crore or above, and they had to file the information in XBRL. NBFC, IFCs and companies engaged in banking and insurance sector are exempted from the filing of financial statement under XBRL at present. But seen, XBRL has not been as effective in early fraud detection as was expected. Intention was that as income tax and sale tax filings data, these MCA will have a similar facility to track companies of unlisted companies. The movement does allow the company's regulator to keep a timely check on movement of financial assertion of large unlisted companies. This amendment will further strengthen early detection of fraud. Friends, thank you for watching this video. If you find this video informative, I request you to please subscribe my channel. Thanking you once again, RV Shekhar, practicing company secretary.